In the 1960s, many provincial English towns decided to change their image from market town to metropolis. The experiment was not a success. There is no plan, no dream of the future, only the nightmare. And then, in the middle of Ipswich, a view of what might have been. The Willis Corroon building, designed by Norman Foster for 1,200 insurance workers in the middle of the 70s. The curtain wall of tinted glass is made of hundreds of individual sheets, bolted together, sometimes at different angles, reflecting a surreal image of the city that surrounds it. The free-flowing contours are reminiscent of the famous vases designed by Alvar Aalto in the 30s and influenced by the glass skyscrapers of Mies van der Rohe a decade earlier. The new technology of the 70s made it possible for Norman Foster to realize this vision, creating an amoebic island in the center of Ipswich which flows to the edge of his site like a drop of water on a glass slide. What is wonderful, as you come into the building, you realize the implication of this free form and what it could mean in terms of making a new workspace. The idea that you bring in light, not only in terms of through the glass, but through the use of colors, the idea of landscape, the idea of the yellow being the sun, the green being the grass, and this kind of making, the making of an internal world for work, which could be wonderful and very healthy and bright. The building was built when I was a student of architecture in London in the 70s. And for me, what was very exciting about it was the fact that one can take a very simple, abstract idea and make it into an office building. It would have been maybe less eccentric if it was just a house or a pavilion. But the fact that it was a workspace, which defied the idea of a kind of a normal idea of an office space, is what makes, for me, this building very important and very exciting. Despite the open plan, it is surprisingly quiet. These globes are for the PA system, which relays a deadening blanket of sound to mop up the noise of over 1,000 computers and telephones. And when the level of daylight is too low, hundreds of discrete ceiling lights are activated. This is the democratic office of the future, imagined by the early modernists, but not fully realized until the 60s and 70s. An open plan in which the only walls are those made by the workers themselves, out of filing cabinets. But what I really like about the inside is the way the glass wall makes the outside world both close but oddly distant. Only on the ground floor does the dream fade, No one Foster wanted to combine the concept of work and leisure in the same space. He did not want to make any distinction between the two. So in his design, they included a gym, a creche, a swimming pool. Sadly, for one reason or another, all have been closed. The one remaining amenity is on the top floor, the staff restaurant. Here you can see the engineering that Norman Foster brings to his work, in which he believes in revealing at every opportunity. This space is used at all times by the workers, not just for eating and drinking, but for business conferences and discussions. And one of the most important features of the restaurant is access to the roof garden. Half an acre of topsoil, seeded with grass and bounded by a privet.
What is wonderful about this building is that suddenly you emerge from the workplace onto this roof, and you are suddenly surrounded as if you are in the landscape, you are in a meadow. This idea of the juxtaposition of pleasure and leisure with the workplace makes this building is really very interesting for me. And then the roof also connects to all the surrounding buildings and the surrounding landscape, and saying that all the green kind of connects to the green around it. But the unfortunate thing, of course, as you look this way, you see this this new addition, which is reminiscent of the Forbidden City, and I wonder what does that have to do with Englishness.
This is surely one of the most unattractive skylines I have ever seen. The village that grew too big for itself. The tragic result of an unplanned urban landscape. In such a landscape, Norman Foster's building stands out as a bold statement of possibility. But for me, the most exciting feature is the way it changes its character from day to night. By day, it's a dark pool reflecting the outside world, hiding what is within. But as the daylight fades, the inside slowly becomes visible. It is as if when the workers have gone home, the building comes alive and reveals a secret identity. This was not my favorite building when it was built, but I have come to like it more and more. It is strange to think that it was completed 20 years ago, but it has a freshness and vigor that does not date. It is not very typical of the work of Norman Foster, but I think it is one of his best. A timeless classic, a vision of what is possible.